All right, look, y'all. I think I reacted to the wrong Unwritten Rules video. I think this is the actual one. I think this is the one that actually explains it. So yeah. Lucky, you know what I'm saying? Lucky. But yeah. Unwritten Rules of Fighting and Retribution in Ice Hockey, man. I don't know how to say his name. I'm not gonna try to pronounce it, but hey. See what it be time. If y'all wanna react, if y'all wanted me to react to any videos, comment. I read all my comments and DM me on Twitter or Instagram.
Then explains the code. The sport of ice hockey is the only sport on the planet that tolerates fighting and retribution, even though their rules prohibit doing so. Referees will penalize players for breaking the rules, but sometimes the players take matters into their own hands. There are unwritten rules that govern how players should behave that you won't find in any rulebook. And there are even specific players on hockey teams whose sole job it is to police the game accordingly. These are the enforcers, otherwise known as goons, tough guys, fighters,
oh my cops. God, this is a fight right here.
And whilst it's their sole job
okay, to police I want to see
the
who
game,
win this.
The code applies to every player on the ice. These unwritten rules are based on mutual respect for your opponent and protecting your teammates. This is the code. The first rule of the code is that they do not talk about the code.
Okay, buddy.
Whilst these rules exist amongst players, there is no official record of the rules of the code, except for this video. And you won't find these in any official rulebook. The NHL, or International Ice Hockey Federation, will always officially decline to comment about any code. This is because they don't want to officially admit that their sport that they govern isn't completely under their control. The players police the game as much as the referees do, and sometimes they police it a little too much. Rule number two, if you do something bad, expect to pay the price. Let's say that you spitefully whack your opponent with a stick.
Dang, and for some reason, I didn't see that, bro. Let me see that again.
Rule number two, if you do something bad,
oh, that's,
expect
bro,
to pay
what is wrong
the
with
price.
You? Men's society, bro. Hall of Fame.
Let's say that you spitefully whack your opponent with a stick, and for some reason, the referees and linesmen completely missed it. No penalty is called against you, and you seemingly get away with it. I guarantee that the other team saw it, and they'll be gunning for you to avenge your crimes. There is now a giant bullseye on your back, with members of the opposing team.
Oh my God,
I just
sneaked up wrong.
One way or another. And if you manage to avoid punishment until the end of the game, just wait until you play them again. I guarantee they won't have forgotten. Your
God.
Crime is not
transferred. Oh my God!
Until you have
that is
the
a hit right in the jaw.
Rule 3. You do not target stars. The best players on most teams are the star players that score goals and assists. There is an unwritten gentleman's agreement that stipulates that if you don't hit our star players, we won't hit yours. Let the stars score the goals and let everyone else do their respective jobs. Should you unfairly target a star player, expect swift retribution as per rule number 2. Rule number 4. Ignore rule 3 if that star breaks rule 2. Sidney Crosby, a generational player that can score goals at will and will one day be enshrined into the Hockey Hall of Fame. A talent so immense that he doesn't need to dive, take cheap shots, or hit anybody when they're down. But he does it anyway. This is totally
okay. You know what? I oh my God, bro. What did I just watch? What did he just do, bro? Just slap him in the balls with your hockey stick, bro.
Shots.
You are, bro. You just earned yourself fuck a platinum badge, but you unlocked another badge, bro. Gold, diamond. You diamond Hall of Fame platinum. Men's society, bro.
Or it's anybody.
Please, you need
down.
To, bro. Everybody, bro. I need everybody on that team to everybody just beat his ass, bro. No one else help him. Everybody beat 87 ass. Every single person. Even on their team, beat his ass too.
But he does it anyway.
Oh my God, bro. What
this
the fuck did I just
totally
watch, bro? What is wrong with you?
Once you're a star player that resorts to these tactics, rule number 3 no longer applies.
Okay, buddy.
And you'll have a bullseye on your back just like everyone else. Rule number 5. No sucker punches. There is a proper decorum to challenge someone to a fight. However, sucker punching someone, i.e. punching them when they're down or not looking, is an unacceptable way of doing so. This is cowardly, and blindsiding someone like this will result in the opposing team taking note. Expect swift retribution as per rule number 2. Lots of it. Rule number 6. Pick on someone your own size or bigger.
To politely ask... He said it's acceptable? That's what he said? Acceptable? It is acceptable? Okay.
It is deemed courteous to politely ask a player if he wants to fight. Exhibit A, Georges Laroque.
You want to? Okay. Square up. Okay, good luck, man.
This is the gentlemanly way of instigating a fight.
Okay, that was the coolest shit I've ever seen in my life. That was very cool. I like that.
Fine example.
Oh my god, he beat your ass now. Etiquette. He beat your ass. Yes. Yes. I love it. Accepted, I love it.
The gloves must come off and helmet visors removed before you fight. Respected enforcers will actually remove their helmets completely and roll up their sleeves. This is to protect their opponent's hands.
Bro,
as
hockey
well as
is so
own.
Cool, bro.
This is the ultimate mark of respect. Rule number 11. You do not punch someone lying down. Once the fight has reached the ground, and one or both combatants have hit the ice, you must stop immediately. They are in a defenseless position. It is dishonorable to hit someone when they're down, especially if they can't defend themselves. The punishment and retaliation for breaking this rule is severe. Rule number 12. You do not fight goalies unless you are a goalie or they instigate it. Goalies, like Stars, have a job to do, and it doesn't involve fighting. Unless they challenge you and it's obvious that they're doing so, leave them well alone. That said, it is acceptable for both goalies to fight each other, even if no incident has happened between them. Rule number 13, brawling is fair game. Rule number 14, be wary of pests. A pest is a player whose sole job it is to antagonize and annoy you and your teammates.
They say that literally is the Boston Bruins. They literally said that's the whole team. That's who they are.
Penalties. They will resort to anything from verbal abuse.
It's funny how they use this. They use them too. It's funny. They use them highlights.
Underhand tactics to licking your face.
No fucking way. No fucking way. No fucking no. Stop. 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 Did not just lick him, bro. Did he just lick him, bro? Did he just lick him? Did he just lick him? Did he just lick him? Bro. Oh my god! Oh my god, bro! What the fuck, bro? My mama calling me irritated, bro. What is going on right now, bro? Did he just lick him, bro? I'm messing up straight. Bro, did he just lick him, bro? Am I crazy right now? My fucking god.
Verbal abuse to underhand tactics to licking your face. They will most likely challenge you to a fight and then proceed to run away, leaving you with an instigator penalty. Be cautious when you challenge them to a fight, because that's exactly what they want you to do. Rule number 15, the golden rule. You stand up for your teammates, whether it's your job or not. Whether you're an enforcer or not, if you are on the ice and foul play happens, you are expected to stand up for your teammates, regardless of size, weight, or star power. These players will stand up for you, through thick and through thin,
Dang.
And it is seen as cowardly to not return the favor.
Dang.
Teammates,
this is
will
brutal,
notice
bro.
If they don't have their back, so be wary because one day it might be you that needs the help. The most interesting thing is that the code is open to interpretation. No two players have the exact same interpretation
My God, bro.
Of the code. But in general, these are the rules that ice hockey players live and die by, even if they're not written down. When regular rules aren't enforced properly, the code dictates how justice is served. In conclusion, there are some amazingly talented players in the sport of ice hockey, and there are people whose job it is to protect them. These men and women have given up being stars themselves, taken lower paychecks, significantly shortened their own careers, and risked their lives and future health, all to protect their teammates when the rules of the game fail to do so. These are noble warriors who will fight with honor and within the unwritten rules of the game. They deserve our absolute respect because they are the enforcers. of the code.
Yep. Hey, man, y'all like, comment, subscribe. Comment, show me yet to next, man. Follow me on Instagram, where I'm most active at. We on the grind of 1K, man, and I'm out.